So 21 Turkish get-ups, 400 meter run, 5 rounds of time, using a barbell for the Turkish there. Normally the Turkish get-up is about full body tension and control while moving under a balanced load. I feel like due to the sheer volume of 105 reps, that's gonna crumple. We're not gonna maintain full control. Using a barbell instead of a kettlebell is funner. I prefer that, it's kind of cool. But the correction needed for that. So I just imagine that as I enter towards the later rounds, that the barbell's gonna wanna rotate a little bit. That can just be more taxing on the shoulder than just the forearm. But hopefully it doesn't rotate too much and cause the elbow to unlock, things like that. What I believe the intention of a Turkish is about is to move slowly but consistently through every phase of the lift up and down there. I like to cup one hand under, one hand over, bringing the barbell assisted into that overhead position. My aim is to have my wrist directly over my shoulder, and my eyes will be in the center of my fist to help enhance balance and stability throughout the duration of the lift. My same side leg is drawn up my heel as close to my glute and slightly outside. My free arm plants between a 90 and a 45 degree angle. From here on out, it's all about vertical movements of the barbell. So the first thing I want to do is torque my shoulder up and off the ground. From there, I drive off my planting foot and put weight into my elbow, and I come up onto that. From there, I continue upward by going all the way to my palm. From here, I can lift my hip high enough to slide my leg back all the way to my knee. My legs look very similar to a lunge position. From there, my hand comes off the ground, and then I'll then stand all the way tall. From here, it's just reversing that process. So the same knee steps back down. I poke the hip out on the side that the bell is on and drive my hand over towards the side. From there, like a baseball player, I slide my back leg all the way through into the front, then going down to my elbow, to my shoulders. If I were going for a high volume workout, a high rep workout, I wouldn't put the bar down and continue to go on from there. If I was done, I'll lower it towards my chest and use two hands to assist it in a controlled manner back down to the ground. And that's how you do a Turkish get up with a barbell. A lot of good ways you can pull it back. Obviously using a kettlebell would be a little less taxing than a barbell. And the other ways of even just going down, so if I had a very beginner client, well, for one, they would not be doing near that volume. And maybe not even a kettlebell. I have some modified versions. Even if mobility was an issue, things like that, ways we can test it is with a drink. It'd be nice to the client and say, I could hold the cap on, but essentially, can they maintain that full extension without getting an angle that would spill their drink?